Hello and welcome to the new session of e-classroom. I'm Shruti Banerjee from Holy Hearts Educational Academy. In our previous video, we have discussed the different chapters which we are going to study in class 9th biology. I hope you have now the broader outlook of what you are going to get into in class 9th biology. So without further ado, let's start with today's topic. Yes, today's topic is Class 9 Biology Chapter 6, Fundamental Unit of Life, Cell Part 1. We are seeing here the Chapter 6 because this is the chapter number from the NCERT book. But for biology, this will be your first chapter. We are going to study it into different small sections. So this is the first part, Fundamental Unit of Life, Cell. So students, the first question that comes to mind is, what is cell? Now cell, the term you must have heard a lot of time in a battery cell which you use in a remote control or any other devices, or as a cellular jail cell, right? So cell, what does cell mean? Cell means a basic small unit of a bigger structure, right? In biology, cell is defined as the structural and the functional unit of living organism. See again the term unit, a small unit of any structure. In biology, the structure is actually what? A living organism. So cell is actually the structural and the functional unit of all living organisms. Now let's break this into smaller parts. Cell is a structural unit. Now what do you mean by structural unit? See the example of a building. Here you see this is a tall building which is again successively has another smaller building and a very smaller building. There are different shapes and sizes of these buildings. What is this building actually made up of? If I tell you to find out the core of the building, what is actually the core of the building? Yes, the core of the building are the bricks. No matter what the shape, no matter what the size of the building, it is actually made from a simple unit, that is the brick, right? So similarly, all the living organism, whether it is as tall as a elephant or it is as small as an ant, whatever may be the size or the shape of the organism, it is basically actually made up of units, small units known as cell, and it is the arrangement of this cell which gives it a structure. That is why cell is defined as the structural unit of living organisms. Now see the second term what it has used. Cell is known as the functional unit of living organism. What do you mean by functional unit? Let's see the example of plant. Now plant is again a living organism. It is performing the function. The leaf of the plant is performing the function of photosynthesis, right? The root of the plant is performing the function of absorbing the water. So what is present inside the leaf? What is present inside the root that is absorbing water or preparing the food? Yes, it is the plant cells. Plant cells are performing the function of the plants, right? Let's take the example of animals. You see there are various animals. It can be a carnivore like a lion or a herbivore like a giraffe or an elephant. No matter what they eat, they have some basic functioning happening, physical functioning like walking, eating, right? There are biochemical functioning happening inside their body, respiration, digestion, excretion. So who is performing all these functions inside the body of the organism? Yes, it is again the core unit, that is the cell. So did you understand? Now cell can be defined as a structural unit because it is giving shape and size to the organism depending upon the arrangement. It is also known as a functional unit of living organism because all the function of living organisms, okay, whether it is physical or biochemical, which is happening inside or outside the body, is again controlled by the cell. Hence, cell can be defined as a structural and functional unit of living organism. Now, when we have now understood what is cell, the second question comes, who discovered this cell? Cell was first discovered by Robert Hooke, a scientist, in 1665. Now, he was performing a project under his fellowship, under his professor, and his professor gave him the project of finding out the structures present inside the body of insects. So he invented a self-made microscope. He invented a microscope and he started observing various things, not only insects, he started observing everything under this magnifying microscope. So the first thing which he's the discovery of the cell, how he came upon to it, he was ideally just taking a thin section from this cork. Now what is this cork? You must have seen this in the glass vials of your homeopathic medicines or of the Alta bottles. If you see, there is a wooden cap over it, right? So that wooden cap is known as cork. Now he cut a thin section of this cork. He cut a very thin slice of this cork and observed it under the microscope as he was observing everything, putting it under it. So when he put this thin section of the cork under his microscope, he saw this kind of a structure, and it resembled the honeycombs, right? Now if you just imagine a honeycomb like structure, you will see it contains this kind of pentagonal or box like small units which are empty. So empty spaces or empty rooms in Latin means cell. Since he observed such a structure inside the slice of a cork or a bark of a tree, he named these empty spaces as cell. So this is how the cell was discovered. So again, I'll repeat it for you, that Robert Hooke in 1665, when he cut a thin section of this cork, put it under the microscope and observed, he saw some honeycomb-like structures which were empty, okay, empty spaces. Hence, he named them cell, which in Latin means empty rooms, right? Now, there were many more scientists who contributed to the study of cell as we know about it today. We know a lot of things about the cell today, and it was because of the step-by-step inventions of the various scientists. The first discovery of the cell, you already know, was done by Robert Hooke. But see what an interesting point it is. He observed dead cells. See here, the cork of the bottle, the cork here is a dead part of the tree. This is not a living part, right? So the first discovery of the cell was from a dead part of the plant. Hence, if a question asks you who discovered dead cells, the answer will be again Robert Hooke. Now, who first discovered living cells, right? First living cells were discovered by Leeuwenhoek, Antony von Leeuwenhoek. He discovered some algal cells from the pond, right? So the question can come that who first discovered living cells, who discovered only cell. If only cell is told and who discovered it first, the answer will be Robert Hooke. But if they say that who discovered first living cell, the answer will be Leeuwenhoek. Right? Now inside the cell there are different structures. One of that structure is nucleus. This we will study in our future videos, what is nucleus. But this structure of nucleus was again discovered by Robert Brown. So inside the cell, the nucleus was discovered by Robert Brown. Now about the functioning, how this cell performs different function, how does it divides and all other features of the cell was proposed in a theory known as cell theory. There were two scientists, Sheldon and Schwann. One was a botanist, another one was a zoologist. Okay, he studied in plants and he studied animals. Together they observed certain features of the cell and proposed it under a theory known as cell theory. Again, very important. Cell theory, what did it propose? It said that all cells arise from pre-existing cells. Now, the question was for all the scientists, like, okay, we discovered some empty structures. Okay, we discovered some living structures. We have discovered this nucleus. But how is this cell coming from? Where is this cell coming from? So this question was answered by Sheldon and Schwann in their cell theory, where they proposed that all cells arise from pre-existing cell, that there is one mother cell, and from that mother cell after division comes the daughter cells. So all cells comes from their parent or the pre-existing cell. Okay, this was the major breakthrough for the discovery, after the discovery of the cell. But this was again incomplete because it was not able to define cell properly, Right, like in cell theory was further modified by Virchow, where he added that all living organisms are made up of cell. Now we said from where the cell is coming, but what is the feature of this cell? Is it a feature of a living or is it a feature of a dead? Because remember, the first cell which was discovered was actually a dead cell. Can this dead cell arise from again the pre-existing cell? No, the feature of pre-existing arising of a new cell from a pre-existing cell will come from only living organism. So this again, cell theory was further modified and a statement was added to it by Virchow, where he said that all living organisms are made up of cell. So if you are asked that what is cell theory, you will be defining it again that the cell theory is given by Sheldon and Schwann, stated that all cells arise from pre-existing cell, and again modified by Virchow, cell theory also states that all living organisms are made up of cell. So see this history, the 6 points, okay, there are hardly 6 points over here. Pause this video or take a screenshot of this page and learn these 6 points, because these are very, very important in terms of your examination point of view. For 1 marks or very short answer, these questions are relatively asked. Okay, so let's recall, what did we study today? We study what is cell, we studied who discovered cell, and what is the history of cell. Okay. Now here are some questions. I have given you 3 questions, very basic questions. Why are cells known as the structural and functional unit of all living organisms? See, here it has been asked why. So you have to explain the reason why cell is called structural and functional unit. Very simple, just now I have explained. Second, what does the cell theory says? Here it has asked what the cell theory proposed. Okay, what were the statements given by the different scientists for regarding the cell theory? This you will be writing over here. And who discovered nucleus? Which scientist discovered the nucleus? Now I want the answer of all these questions in the comment section below. Okay, you don't have to take out any other copy or page or something. Just review this video, learn it, and very honestly, after you have learned all the points, understood all the points, solve these answers in the comment section. So I will know that you are ready for the next video. And also to make it a point that it takes at least 5 to 4 days for me to upload another video. So you are getting a lot of time. It is hardly 3 to 4 slides that you have to go through and learn. So 3 to 4 days is enough for you to write these 3 questions. So be very honest and diligent. Learn and write these 3 questions in the comment section below. Okay, I'll be looking forward to it. So that's all for today's part 1. Thank you. Stay safe. See you in the next video.